million baby kisses I'll deliver. If you will only sing the Swanee River, rock-a-bye, your rock-a-bye baby with a Dixie melody.
Julie!
She's left, sir.
When? Where to? Was she packed?
Yes, sir.
How long ago?
Oh, about half an hour ago.
Do you know where, Henry?
Well, all I know is the airport.
New York.
She wouldn't let me take her.
Thanks, Henry. Steve, see what you can get me on the next plane out of here.
Now, look,
why do it, will you? Henry, get me some stuff in a bag. I don't get it. If something was on her mind, why not wait and talk? You don't just get up and go. It doesn't make sense. And my pal, Steve, lets me stand out there and sing my brains out for another hour. Why doesn't he tell me? Haven't I got a right to know what it's all about when she gets a sudden crazy notion like this?
You think it was so sudden, Asa?
What else?
I'm thinking of the questions she asked tonight.
What questions?
Were you happy? Did you think of singing anymore?
I've told her 1,000 times.
You told her. And tonight she heard you sing.
So what? You saw it coming, Papa. And Steve. Everybody but me. All right, so I sang. Crowd was yelling. She told me to go ahead, so I got wound up a little. But I told her it doesn't mean a thing to me anymore. I was happy this way, the way we were. Steve, how about it?
Give me time, will you?
Hey, son.
It's gonna be all right, Mama. I hate to run away like this on your anniversary party.
If not for my party, if I didn't have to see a nightclub,
no,
I...
Oh, fine. Now we got tears, everything is solved. Congratulations, Mama.
Mama, don't be silly. Don't you see whether we'd had the party or not?
Okay, you're all set. If you're gonna make it, you better get going.
Henry! Henry!
It's ready, sir.
Goodbye, Mama. I don't know how long I'll be gone, but don't get back soon. Anytime you want to go home, Steve will take care of everything, and I'll see you in Washington, maybe. Take care of yourself, Mama. You too, Papa. So long, Tom. Steve.
Wait a second. I'm driving you to the airport.
You may think you mean it, Al, but you'll never be happy away from show business. And someday, if I ever feel you quit just for my sake, if I'm ever sure you want to sing more than you want me,
no, I'm telling you, Steve, there's not a trace of her. She got here all right, but didn't check in any place. I've turned the town upside down. She hopped in a car, I guess, and just disappeared. Steve, I need you. How about you coming here?
Tomorrow.
Good, I'm waiting for you.
So long, Al.
So long. Maybe I don't know my own mind, but she was what I wanted. The only thing I ever got for myself outside a show racket. But I guess I've just been kidding myself. Love, a girl, a couple of words I must have picked up out of a song. She says so, I've been dying to sing all the time. All I ever wanted was a cheering mob. Well, I'll say this about the cheering mob. That was love, brother. For 20 years, nobody ever walked out on me. Okay. She says so, I'm back where I was, singing for a living. And it ain't a bad feeling. Only question now is, how fast can I get back to work? Tom, that script of yours I read the other day back home. It's good. That's the show I'd like to do. If you'll take a chance with a character like me. I'll consider it. Want to start right away. First thing tomorrow. What's wrong with tonight? Why don't we kick it around, talk about songs? Where's the script?
Oh, I don't walk around with it.
Well, let's get it. Why didn't I bring the one we had out in California?
You mean this one?
You dog. Come to Papa.
Is it true what they say about the kids? Does the sun really shine all the time? Do the sweet magnolias blossom at everybody's door? And do the folks keep eating possum till they can't eat no more? Is it true what they say about Swanee? Is a dream by that stream so sublime? Do they laugh? Do they love like they do in every song? If it's true, that's where I belong. I said, do they laugh? Do they love like they do in every song? That's pretty. If it's true, that's where I belong.
You're
on. The bells are ringing for me and my gal. The birds are singing for me and my gal. Everybody's been knowing to a wedding they're going, and for weeks they've been sewing. Every Susie and Sal, they're congregating for me and my gal. The parson's waiting for me and my gal. And sometime I'm going to build a little home for two, for three or four or more in Loveland for me and my gal. The bells are ringing for me and my gal. The birds are singing for me and my gal. And sometime I'm going to build a little home for two, for three or four or more in Loveland for me and my gal.
If you don't mind, that's all tonight. What's the matter, Al? Go on with the show. Leave me out of the finale. I tell you, nothing's the matter. Just comes a night that... How long can you go on knocking yourself out? For what? They're $4 and their applause? Holy smoke, don't know what hit me. Never walked off like that in my life.
What's the matter, Al?
Just can't take it anymore. I used to live for this. The kick's gone. Just hard work now. So what am I killing myself for? What am I getting out of it? You were always telling me, how about something for myself? Well, how about it? That's what I want now, some laughs, fun, just for me. Al, what happened to you?
Sit down, Tom. I think we got some news for you.
The boy is sick, Papa. This he tries to hide from us. Papa, you agree or not?
I agree.
So why do you sit?
Because it is a sickness not for doctors.
Please, no riddles.
Mama, just go on pasting in Asa's scrapbook. You will understand.
Where will he get a good Jewish meal over there, Papa?
Mama, without Jewish meals, Gentiles are surviving year after year. Monte Carlo. Before they take your money away, they make you dress up yet.
saw a dozen bluebirds today in the backyard. And he is looking. A girl with Asa. Who is it?
And if you knew, Mama, what would you know?
Again a new girl.
Mama, with a man, it's only natural.
This is soup.
Eat. You'll have another plate.
You don't know, Steve, how we appreciate your visits. I just come for the food.
Oh, for what it costs to come from New York, you could buy a better meal than this.
So this winter it's again Florida for you, sir.
Oh, he's having a great time.
Yeah, so he always says.
Wait, you hear the radio? All day long, a Mr. Bing Crosby.
Oh, yeah. He's doing all right.
Crooning.
Very good.
It's also singing.
And the name, Bing. Go explain, people.
But he's got something.
Yeah? He's got something.
There was a time they played Asa's records. That was a joy. But for years now, you'd think Asa isn't alive anymore.
All right, Mama, all right. We're eating, not singing. Give him the fish.
This week it's very good, Steve. And the little horse radish?
Mm-hmm.
There. But be careful.
Don't worry. This stuff got me once. But I take it easy now. Very easy.
I'm afraid this wicket was extra strong. On his back, Papa. I'll bring the chicken. Buying a horse, that I understand. But buying a fighter, a human being, how is this, Papa?
Foolishness, a tragedy. That's how it is. A whole world is on fire. A Hitler swallows nations. Millions of our people driven, tortured, killed like flies. You don't want to sing? All right. But horses, fighters.
Hello, Cannon. This is Steve. Tell me first, is Mama any better?
I'm afraid not. The pneumonia came so fast. Did you reach Asa?
No, I called Havana twice. He's off cruising on somebody's boat. They're getting in touch with him by radio. Of course, I don't know how long it'll take him to sail back to Havana and catch a plane.
You will keep trying, please.
Sure, I will.
Thank you very much, Steve. Bye.
You all right, Papa? I wish I'd been here.
She understood, Asa. It's no sense to feel sorry. It was a prayer for Mama. For Mama and all our people. For their suffering, like millions today.
I know.
You do? Come, Asa.
Sit down, Asa. I'll get you something.
Something to eat, or maybe a cold drink?
No, thanks, Pop. I don't want anything. Who looks after you here now?
Oh, someone comes in. It's all arranged. I think I have to lie down for a few minutes. Just on the couch.
Sure, go ahead.
Just a few minutes. You'll stay.
Of course I will. I'm going to call Steve in New York.
Fine.
Papa, how about coming away with me for a while? Take a little trip somewhere.
We're in the war now, Asa. This is no time for trips.
Week or so, just for a change.
Thank you. But prize fights, racetracks, that change I wouldn't need.
Why do you say that, Papa?
I merely said a fact.
You hate everything I've been doing, don't you?
Asa, it's your life to throw away.
What do you want me to do?
Who can tell another man?
You want me to get in the war and fight at my age?
A man finds ways to do everything. But if he's so busy fighting himself... We'll talk later.
Hello? Oh, he's not. Willie, come in. Leave word for Mr. Martin to call Washington this number anytime before 11 o'clock. Yeah, that's right. Thanks.
I'll do that.
Why, you...
Hello, Al.
How are you?
Fine. When did you get in?
About an hour ago.
How's Papa doing?
Pretty good, Steve. Take a little nap in there right now. Yeah, he's fine. Sit down. Tell me the news. What are you doing around here anyway?
I got a date in 15 minutes.
This time of night?
I flew down to see a bunch of generals at the War Department.
Who?
Son, I've enlisted.
Enlisted? Well, you're four times older than I am. Don't tell me you're going to fight.
Sure. From behind the desk.
Yeah, quit kidding. What's this about?
Entertainment for the kids overseas.
Getting shows together?
A little more than that. You see, lots of entertainers are over there now. Good talent, but they got to have more and the best. Those kids are stuck away in Pacific jungles, Aleutians, Africa, Iceland. It'd be a terrific boost to morale if they could get the top names to go over. The biggest performers in the country. That's the job they want me to tackle. I guess they figured if I can manage Jolson for 20 years, I can lick anything.
Yeah, they're right. You won't have any trouble, Steve. Big name stars will go once they know what's needed.
Just a question of getting a couple of them to lead the way.
Sure. Darn big job, Steve. Proud of you.
Save it, pal.
You know, 7 or 8 years ago, I could have been the guy to start this thing off.
What's the matter with now?
Ah, don't be silly. These kids are hip. They want the stuff they heard back home, the top guys they know. How many of them know me now?
But everybody in show business does. And they followed you before.
I'm thinking of the kids.
Now, better get going. See you here later, huh?
Yeah.
So long, Al.
Steve. Maybe I'll walk over with you.
going to have a lot of fun tonight. You know, they've been telling us we're going to get some big entertainers up here. And believe it or not, we've got one of them with us right now. In fact, when I heard this man was coming, I said, they're making good in a big way. I don't know what the name means to you, but when I was your age, it meant the world's greatest entertainer, Al Jolson.
Thanks, Colonel. If I'm half as good as that send-off, I may leave here a second lieutenant. Hello, gang. I sing. You don't believe me, write and ask your grandmothers. You know, it's wonderful working for guys like you, because if you don't like it, where can you go? It's me or nothing. All kidding aside, fellas, my stuff isn't what you were hearing back home when you left, but you might like an old one, the way you used to do them. Orchestra?
We leave home expecting to find a bluebird, hoping every cloud will be silver lined. But we all return, and as we live, we learn that we left our happiness behind. The bird with feathers of blue is waiting for you back in your own backyard. You'll see your castle in Spain through your window pane, back in your own backyard. Oh, you can go to the east, go to the west. Someday you'll come, weary at heart, back where you started from. You'll find your happiness lies right under your eyes, back in your own backyard.
It's a big boot singing to those kids tonight, only I guess they thought I was a little old-timey.
They loved it. You heard them yell.
Yeah. Well, I guess it was just the idea of something from home. Is that my plane?
They'll call you. You ought to relax.
How do you do that, Colonel? See, it's kind of tough doing this after laying off a long time and not sure you're getting over it. That's what kills you.
You didn't get over any better in Duluth 20 years ago.
Duluth?
Minnesota. That's where I first heard you.
Well, I'll be darned. The old Lyceum Theater.
That's right.
Gets a little chilly in Duluth.
I played hooky from high school one afternoon to see Robinson Crusoe.
Oh, boy, that's going way back.
To me, you were the greatest thing that ever lived.
Thanks. Wait a second. Did you sneak in that afternoon? Did you pay?
Paid.
Then that's all right.
The first time I hit New York, the only thing I wanted to do was go right to the theater to see you.
Oh, now I understand about tonight. Why, you're just an old fan. I could have knocked you over reciting Little Bo Peep.
Yeah, you could.
Ready to take off, sir.
Thank you.
Well, here we go. Look, Colonel, tell the boys they'll try to get back. Tell them a lot of big stars will be along soon, but not to forget me.
They'll never forget you were one of the early ones.
Well, that's something. Colonel Bryant, you've been wonderful. Hope we meet up someday back home.
I hope we do. In fact, if you're ever in Hollywood...
Hollywood? Movies?
I've produced a few.
Well, that's a funny one. I've played in a few of them in my time.
I remember every one of them.
Afraid I do, too. So long, Duluth. Good luck.
So long, Mr. Jolson. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
looking over a four-leaf clover that I overlooked before. One leaf is sunshine, the second is rain. Third is the roses that grow in the lane. No need explaining, the one remaining is someone that I adore. I'm looking over a four-leaf clover that I overlooked before. When the red robin's out bobbing along, along, there'll be no more sobbing when he starts robbing his own. Sweet song, oh, wake up, you sleepyhead, get up, get out of bed, cheer up. The sun is red, live, love, laugh and be happy. What if I've been through, now I'm walking through fields of flowers. Rain may glisten, but still I listen for hours and hours. I'm just a kid again, doing what I did again, singing a song. When the red robin starts bobbing along. When the red robin starts bobbing along. Give my regards to Broadway, remember me to Herald Square. Tell all the gang at 42nd Street that I will soon be there. Whisper of how I'm yearning to mingle with that old-time throng. Give my regards to old Broadway and say that I'll be there ere long. Chinatown, my Chinatown, where the lights are low, hearts that know no other land, drifting to and fro. Dreamy, dreamy, our Chinatown. Come and dance abroad. I've seen life, and life seems bright. Hey, dreamy, dreamy China. Dreamy, dreamy China. China. Chinatown. I'm just wild about Harry. Harry's wild about me. The heavenly blizzard of his gizzard fill me with ecstasy. He's sweet just like chocolate candy and like honey from the bee. I'm just wild about Harry. Harry's wild about, I can't live without. Harry's wild about me. And like honey from the bee, say I'm just wild about Harry. Harry's wild about, I can't live without. Harry's wild about me.
Everything down. We're coming into New York.
Come on. Let's wake up. That's right.
The cutest little.
I'd say it was gonna be just fine.
When'd they bring me back?
Night before last. Let's get some more of this down before we talk, hmm?
What was it hit me?
A little fever you picked up way back.
I've seen you someplace.
You certainly have.
Where?
Right here.
When?
This morning.
This morning?
When you woke up.
Oh. Wouldn't forget you. You're pretty.
Oh, just a baby face.
How'd you know?
You told me.
Me? When?
This morning.
I said that?
My friend, you sang it.
You have to keep doing that.
You have to keep talking.
I sang it, huh?
More or less.
How was I? In good voice?
Oh, you can do better, I imagine.
You wouldn't know yourself. You never heard me sing.
Well, to be honest with you...
That was before your time, honey.
A little bit.
Of course, you might have come across me in the history books.
Oh, no, I wouldn't say that. I remember my folks talking about you.
Well, I'd like to meet them. But I don't imagine I'd be finding them up north.
No, you wouldn't. You'd be finding them in Arkansas. Their name is Clark, and their daughter's name's Ellen. Ellen Clark. Saves a lot more questions, doesn't it?
Sure does.
Now we're going to lie back and take a nice, long rest.
Ellen, honey, look, there's somebody I got to talk to.
Tomorrow,
No, 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 look, I just want to let Steve Martin know I'm all right.
Mr. Martin knows. So does Papa.
Papa? He's here, too?
He's positively darling.
Well, where are they? I want to see him.
Tomorrow.
Now, look, baby, as far as I'm concerned, tomorrow was always the middle of next year.
Now, always rushing around like that is just about the worst thing for anybody.
Oh, you don't say.
You're bound to do most everything wrong.
Thanks, honey. Arkansas may feel that way about it.
Now you take animals back on the farm. Pigs, for instance. Never rushing around. Except, of course, if they see a sudden big shadow, an airplane or a hawk. That scares them and gets them all confused. You know, I've always believed people who rush around get confused the same way. You were going to say something?
Yeah. Wouldn't care to see anybody today.
Just as you say, Mr. Jolson. My, we'll soon be smart as pigs.
Hello, Papa.
Hey, sir.
Steve.
Jolson, loafing in bed.
Well, he looks fine. I would positively know him any place.
What gets me is how they tell a fever from his normal condition.
How do you feel, eh, sir?
Okay. Had quite a tour for yourself, huh? Well, gave it a whirl.
Too big a whirl, maybe.
Steve, I want you to tell him I'll be okay in a couple of weeks and ready to hop off again.
That's not wise, eh, sir?
In fact, it sounds positively silly to me.
Uh-oh.
Boys as sick as he's been are sent away someplace for 6 months to rest.
Now, look.
See, Ellen thinks so, too.
Oh, so it's Ellen already.
Papa doesn't lose a minute.
And just what do you call him?
Canter, mostly.
So far, that is.
That fever's gonna be in his system a long while. And if he goes hopping around, he's apt to come down bad.
Where do you get all those big answers, honey?
By just relaxing, which is what you ought to do for a change.
Oh, brother.
You mean like back home, maybe?
Well, first thing my folks do almost any time, we just sit down and take off our shoes.
Sister, his socks are even off and it ain't helping.
Well, if he'd just forget how important he is for once, he might do a sensible thing.
What do you mean by that?
Just what I said.
Now listen, sweetheart. Whenever I've had a job to do, I've always done it, see?
That's what I mean. However, I just came in to say goodbye.
Goodbye? Where are you going?
I've been transferred to an army hospital in Arkansas, and I'm leaving first thing in the morning.
Walking out on me, huh?
Oh, you'll be just fine.
You mean I won't be seeing you again?
Well, I go off duty in a few minutes, and I'll have to be packing the rest of the night. Goodbye, Mr. Martin.
Good luck, Ellen.
You can't make cracks at me and just walk out. I don't want to talk to you.
Really won't have time.
Oh, that's too bad. Because I thought on your last evening how nice if you and I could have had dinner together.
Well, now, I will have to have dinner, won't I?
Delightful. At 7, shall we say?
That'll be just fine.
And for dessert, Ellen?
No dessert. Just coffee, Papa.
Thank you.
And how will your daughter have her steak?
Rare.
Not my daughter. A friend.
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Papa, you see, is a certain kind of modern term.
I understand, sir.
He understands.
You sure this is the kind of place you wanted?
Exactly. Why not?
A little swanky.
Well, that's me tonight, swanky. You know? A waltz is my specialty. Of course, mine is not exactly a cheek-to-cheek style, but if you would honor me...
I'd love it. But wouldn't you like to say what you wanted to say to me first?
Remarkable girl. As a matter of fact, I only wanted to thank you.
For what?
The things you said to my son today.
A little brutal, wasn't I?
But delightful. You know, he's a very nice boy. Of course, that's a father's opinion.
You could be right.
Thank you. The only thing, he never learned how to live. And you know, there was a look in his eyes when you spoke to him that way that I'd never seen before. To me, it was like the first step when a baby learns to walk.
Powerful baby, isn't he?
Powerful.
And he'll go right on singing when he should.
I'm afraid so.
You know, in his condition, that could be bad.
A baby doesn't walk in a day. But the important thing, I have a feeling he won't forget what you said. In fact, if I know my boy, he'll have to see you again. If he does.
I don't think I'd mind that at all.
And now?
Delighted.
There's something wrong?
Just getting back into my shoes.
Remarkable.
Right. And I'm through arguing with you. You're not going overseas again, then that's all there is to it. You hear me?
You don't know what a kick it was to be singing again, Steve.
Sure I do.
No, listen. I found out something. I've missed it every day since I quit. I realize now, I've only been half alive. All of a sudden, I've got a terrific yen. What do you say, Steve? What if I wanted to get back on Broadway again? Think it's too late?
What do you mean, too late?
Don't kid me, pal.
Listen, the parade may pass some guys, but any time you want to get back into business...
I wish I could believe it.
You're crazy.
All right. See what you can dig up for me, Steve. Broadway show, anything. Will you go to work on it?
Sure.
Right away?
Yeah, right away. But meanwhile, you gotta promise me you're not going overseas again.
Okay.
Now we're getting someplace.
All right. I'll stay home and just make a little tour of these GI hospitals around the country.
Now wait. Ellen said to knock off everything for at least 6 months.
Oh, Ellen did?
Yeah, Ellen did.
You know, a baby face could be wrong about something.
Baby face. You got the cutest little baby face. There's not another one could take your place. Oh, baby face. My poor heart is jumping. You should have started. Oh, baby face. I'm up in heaven when I'm in your fond embrace. I didn't need a shove, cause I just fell in love with your pretty baby face. Baby face. You got the cutest little, oh, you got a baby face. There's not another one could take your place, oh, baby face. My poor heart is jumping. You should have started some, oh, baby face. I'm up in heaven when I'm in your fond embrace. I didn't need a shove, cause I just fell in love with your pretty, oh, you baby face. Baby face, you got the cutest, oh, you got a baby face. There's not another one could take your place. Oh, baby face. My poor heart is jumping. You should have started. Oh, baby face. I'm up in heaven when I'm in your fond embrace. You're like a breath of spring when slowly say about your baby face.
Don't know why I'd want to see anybody like you again, but couldn't wait to hit this place. Now, isn't that Daffy?
Haven't you been singing too much lately?
That's what I missed about you. Nobody to boss me around, give me the answers. But I'm glad to see you. In fact, been thinking about you. And now and then, this is really Daffy, I found myself thinking,
I could even get romantic about that pest. You know how your mind runs away with you sometimes.
Sure. Mine does with every other man I meet. It's fun.
But not exactly fun when I do it, hon.
Why not?
Well, for instance, if the gal happens to be young, like you, I suddenly remember I'm not so young.
I don't see what difference years make. I knew a couple once, same age. Whew. It was terrible.
Was, huh? Then I remember something else. I was married once.
I know.
Made an awful flop of it.
Why?
It seems all I cared about was singing. That didn't give marriage much of a chance.
You're afraid you might do the same thing again?
I guess I don't have to worry about that.
No?
Because I walked out on all the singing a long time ago.
But you still want to, don't you?
Yeah. But the point is, the world ain't exactly clamoring for me anymore.
Well, now, I'm just sure the world would again, if you wanted it to.
I like you.
And if it does, just see that you get more out of life than singing.
Try and remember that, baby, if it ever happens. I'm afraid I'd need a little help, though. Might have to ask somebody like you where to start.
Well, now, if I'm not around, you just try relaxing.
Take off my shoes?
Anything you get fun out of, you just go right ahead and do it.
Well, right now, it'd be terrific fun to kiss you.
Well, then I would.
After you've gone and left me crying, after you've gone, there's no denying, you'll feel blue, you'll feel sad, you'll miss the best spell you've ever had. Oh, baby, there'll come a time, now don't forget it, there'll come a time when you'll regret it someday.
What is it?
Well, a lung was infected. They had to operate, cut out the bad spot.
Now he's going to be fine. He's in good hands. Kevin, hello?
Yes, Steve.
Believe me, will you? And there's no sense you making a trip out here. I'll phone you again tomorrow. Goodbye. Why, the doc says you got a constitution like an ox. You're gonna mend so fast, nobody will believe it. And do you know something else? He says you're as much all there today as you ever were in your life. Hello, Ellen.
Hello, Steve. I thought you might be needing some answers right now.
No. Just a good lung, baby. Got one of those.
Why, you're breathing, honey. Now who'd want a man to do more than that?
I don't believe it. Let me talk to him.
He doesn't believe it. Hello, Papa. You know this gal gets away about everything.
But yesterday out of the hospital, today married, is this wise? I mean... Never mind, it's lovely. Let me talk to her. Here.
Hello, Papa.
Nana.
Well, it's really Papa now.
Yes, it's wonderful.
You should see this ring. And I got some orchids here. If they were any bigger, I couldn't see around them.
I must see both of you. I'm coming out there.
When?
When? After the high holidays, in 2 weeks.
Good. We'll have a nice place waiting for you. In fact, we're moving into a house today.
Oh, you've got a house already?
A beautiful one out in the valley. It's been rented up to a few months ago, but we can get into it now. It's Al's house.
Al's house?
Yes, the one Julie built.
Oh.
Imagine looking for a place in these times. And one sitting out there just as vacant and as pretty as can be. It doesn't make sense, at least not in Arkansas. You understand, don't you, Papa?
Yes, I think I do.
Now, you get out here when you said. In 2 weeks. We'll be expecting you.
Yes, Ellen. Yes. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Papa. Well, let's get moving. Well, now, isn't this a deal?
Deal?
Beautiful. Don't you understand English? I haven't had time to do much around here yet, but I'll get going in a couple of days. First thing, we'll get a little fresh air in here. And a little dusting wouldn't do any harm. Well, now, aren't you two in pretty poses? How about getting some of those bags upstairs? Go ahead. Steve, you do it. Mr. Jolson, you come over here and sit down. Boy, I've been hoping somebody can play checkers around here. I can keep myself in pin money. Al, honey. It's cruel to bring you back to this house.
No, baby.
I know it is. I must be crazy.
Fine time to tell me.
I just didn't want any ghosts around. I wanted you to wrestle with them right here, so you know where you stood about the past, and so I'd know, too. That's what I thought.
Well, that's right, baby.
No, it isn't.
Now, look. If there are any ghosts around, this is a place to make them come out and fight. That's what I'm getting to like about you.
You're just saying that.
And I'm meaning that.
Well, promise me, if this house gets you down, when you can't take it anymore, I want you to tell me straight out.
Like I could keep something from you if I wanted to.
I also move pianos, and my heavy cleaning is in demand all over town. Come on, you two. You got years to do that.
Here, I'll take a couple of those. No argument, honey.
All right, you win.
Look when she lets me win. Say, anybody thought about getting help?
How would you like to have Henry and Alice back?
You kidding? Where do you expect to find Henry and Alice?
Already found them. Where?
They'll be here tonight. Quit their jobs and flying back here on broomsticks.
No.
Go on listening to the radio like that forever. Likes music, I guess.
Wouldn't be surprised.
He looks to me like a man about ready to go back to work.
You mean sing?
Don't you think he can, Steve?
Sure.
But he doesn't think so, does he?
Well, it's only natural.
That lung's all healed.
I suppose it is. Well, I can see why he'd be afraid.
Or is he afraid that nobody wants to hear him? In that case, he'd tell himself it was his lung, wouldn't he?
Why worry about it, Ellen? He's happy enough, isn't he?
Not if what he wants is to be back at work. You think he does?
This is a laugh. There was one woman once who wanted him like this, living a little and not singing his head off. And here you are now. Not exactly a tactful guy, am I?
Yes, you are, Steve. I really want him to do both. All I know, it can't be good when the natural part of a man is just molding away. You didn't answer me, Steve. I asked you if you thought he'd like to be back singing again.
Of course he would. He'd like to be right back in the middle of show business again.
He said so?
Yes. Just before he started that hospital tour. Told me to go to work on it. But look, Ellen, there's something I haven't told anybody and wouldn't tell him in a million years. I did go to work, and the answer is nobody wants him. Broadway, radio. Nobody would risk a nickel on him. A new crop of singers has pushed Jolson right off the map. If he tries for a comeback, he'll take the beating of his life. It would kill him to have to face the truth about it. So do you see what I mean, Ellen? If he thinks he's through because of his lung, even if he's lying to himself a little, it's the kindest thing that could have happened. Ellen, do you understand what I'm saying?
Papa.
See, as good as my word.
And I'll tell you right now, you're going to stay a long time.
Well, if I like it here, I won't argue. Henry, I don't believe it.
It's nice to see you again, Cantor.
My goodness, it's a long time.
Many years.
You don't look a day older.
Neither do you.
What a comfort we are to each other.
I don't have to ask if you're happy.
Oh, I don't know.
Miserable?
Husband out of work, lazing around the house all day. Not good. But Steve says he isn't wanted anymore, and he'd take a beating if he tried to sing again. I'm wondering, Papa, which would be the worst beating? Trying or just never singing again at all?
It's hard to say, Ellen.
You mean if I were smart, I'd mind my own business.
But women in love never do.
Is that bad?
Bad, good. It's history.
You know, it's nice you're here, Papa. I've been sort of waiting for you. Dinner must be ready. We'll have to get up some special entertainment for Papa.
Me? Entertainment?
Aren't you the man who likes to go dancing in swanky restaurants?
That was in my younger days.
Oh, there's a benefit show for the community chess next week. A lot of big stars are going to be on the program. Would you like to go?
Nice. Very nice.
I'll see that we're there.
Al?
Sure, fine.
Of course, give Papa a real thrill. You ought to be on that stage that night yourself.
What doing, honey? Telling jokes?
What you always did.
Yeah?
Just a song or two.
Bet you want it be enough.
Oh, I don't know. If you sound as good as you do when you sing in the bathroom.
Bathroom? You just hum a little. With all that resonance in there, you sound like Caruso. Don't you know that's why people sing in the bathroom?
And you just specially like it, don't you?
Love it.
Well, why don't you try coming out of the bathroom for a change? The public might love it, too.
What are you trying to do? Get me back to work or something?
Well, I certainly don't want a man lazing around the house all the rest of his life.
You know, you sound like you're only half kidding, honey.
About half.
Only half, huh? Well, then, in that case, tell you what to do, Steve. You hop to New York, get a show together for me. Tell him not to worry about my recent operation. Of course, I haven't got the breath for those high notes anymore. A radio. That'd be better. They ought to be wild to have me. Name like Jolson. Name that Bobby Sox has never heard of. That's true. And the style of singing that went out with button shoes. Why did you find that out already, Steve? Find out what? You know what. I was going to make a big comeback. What'd you find out? That they were dying to have me back.
Well, I really didn't get started, but there was a lot of interest.
Oh, I see.
Of course, without your name in lights on Broadway and making oodles of money, I guess it wouldn't be singing, would it?
What do you mean?
During the war, you sang just to be doing something, for the fun of it.
Sure, but that was then.
But even now, I can't see why you'd have to be worried about a little old benefit.
There's going to be 5,000 people at that little old benefit in a big theater. Not a thing to worry about. Except whether I can put two notes together and whether they can hear me past the second row.
You can prove that to yourself quick enough.
Come on, sweetheart, what's the use talking about it?
Okay, if you're sure you can't.
What if I wasn't sure? I don't see anybody breaking down doors to get me on that benefit.
Maybe if they knew you wanted to.
Let's drop it, baby, huh?
Sure. How about a game of checkers tonight, Papa?
No, thank you, Ellen. I couldn't eat another thing.
Pretty tune. That's the big one right now. Make the order for these crooners.
They sure sing this stuff today nice and easy, don't they? Who says you need all the voice in the world to put a song over?
La-da-dee-dee-dee-dum. La-da-dee-da-da-dee-da-da-dum. 'Cause I only have eyes for you, dear. The moon may be high, But I can't see a thing in the sky, 'cause I only have eyes for you. I don't know if we're in a garden or on a crowded avenue. You are here, so am I. Maybe millions of people pass by, but they all disappear from view. And I only have eyes for you.
Must be the resonance in here.
Resonance, of course.
Okay, Steve. If they can use me on that benefit.
You win.
Another game, Papa.
Another game, Steve.
I'm glad he's in shape again, Steve. But actually, I got too big a list of stars right now. Every year, the program's too long. You know how it is.
Yeah, I know. But if you could still get a big name, you'd grab it. You just don't want Jolson.
Now, Steve.
10 years ago, you'd be kissing his feet to get him.
Be reasonable. All I'm trying to do is get a big turnout for a benefit. I've got to have names that mean something.
I don't care what you got to have. When Al Jolson says he'll appear, the guy you and I remember when he was bigger than your whole list put together, I'm not going back to that guy with some lame excuse that adds up to only one thing. He's not wanted. I can't do it, Charlie, and you're not going to make me do it.
All right, Steve. He's on.
Name's a little hard to find, baby. It's at the bottom there. And many others. That's me. Nice day, huh?
Yeah, real nice. Let's go.
Oh, no, wait, please. There's one fella I've got to hear.
It's great to go on there to finish, except there won't be any audience.
Hey, where is everybody? Seriously, I guess I've got a few old friends out there. Who else will be hanging around at this hour? So I'm going to sing you an old one. Just one. Let you go home. By the way, a nice quiet one so we won't disturb the people who sleep. Just like we rehearsed it, pal.
Climb up on my knee, sonny boy. Boy, you're only three, sonny boy. You've no way of knowing, there's no way of showing what you mean to me, sonny boy. When there are gray skies, I don't mind the gray skies. You make them blue, sonny boy. Friends, friends may forsake me. Let them all forsake me. I still have you, sonny boy. You're sent from heaven, and I know your worth. You've made a heaven for me here on earth. And the angels grew lonely, took you because they were lonely. I'm lonely too, so.
Singing for a lot of old-timers.
I liked it, and I'm not an old-timer.
But you happen to be very nice. Better watch the road, honey.
Amazing how he can still get you with a corny old song like that.
I think he can still get anybody singing anything.
Singing styles have changed a little, Ralph.
I don't know about that, but I know one thing. His voice is better now than it ever was. Warmer, more heart. Oddly enough, a certain newspaper columnist brought me a picture idea a few weeks ago. The Life of Jolson. He had to bring that idea to me, an old fan. Listening to that voice tonight, I kept thinking, if you could give people a real chance to hear him again. Bit of a tough one, though.
It was a beating, wasn't it?
What?
This whole thing tonight that I plagued you into doing.
Why, it wasn't anything, honey. I just said to myself, now in Arkansas, we'd look at it this way. I know I'm not headlining this show. In fact, got a hunch you don't even want me on it. You know, half this crowd didn't want to hear me sing, and the other half's only sticking around for old time's sake. I know all that. Didn't come here for glory. It just came to do something I wanted to do, so... Hey.
I don't care. You were absolutely marvelous tonight.
Well, there you are. And I got something out of my system. In fact, a couple more jobs like tonight, I'm a pretty happy man. So what are you talking about?
Uh. just is. No, that's all right. Who? Bryant. Oh, yes, how are you? You really liked it, didn't you, pal? It's nice of you to call and tell me. No, no, that's okay. I hadn't gone to bed yet. Thanks a lot. Why, sure. Oh, anytime. I'm generally home. Thanks again. Good night. Bryant?
Mr. Bryant.
How are you, Mr. Bryant?
You still don't know me, do you? Colonel Bryant, the Aleutians.
Duluth, Minnesota.
That's right.
Well, if it ain't old Duluth, it had to be an old fan. I'm glad to see you. Come on out and meet the family. They'll love you. See, they're fans of mine, too. Brother, how many members of that club still around? Meet Colonel Bryant. My wife, Mrs. Jolson.
How do you do?
How do you do?
My father, Steve Martin.
Glad to know you, Colonel. How are you, sir? Glad to know you, sir.
How do you do? This is a fellow who phones in the middle of the night to tell me I'm terrific. Don't you love him?
Mad about it.
See? Old homeboy. Sit down. Stay for lunch with us, will you?
Oh, thanks. I'd like to.
Oh, honey, you want him to stay for dinner, too, because up in the Aleutians, if it hadn't been for the pat on the back this fella gave me, I was worried and scared stiff, picked me right up off the floor.
In fact, you can bring your clothes and move in, Colonel Bryant.
Oh, let's forget the Colonel. I'm just a picture producer again.
Oh, I didn't tell you that. Came from Hollywood all the time. How's it feel to be back making movies?
Well, they're always tough, except when you get a really exciting idea. And I got one last night listening to you.
Yeah?
I didn't sleep much. This morning I was still at it, so I thought I'd come over and talk to you about it.
Well, what's that?
Motion picture.
You mean you want me to play a part or something? Me?
No, a picture about you. Your whole career. Sound crazy?
My friend is goofy as can be.
Why?
Why? Well, last night should tell you why.
Last night brought me out here.
Yeah, you, pal, and a few hundred others, but you make pictures today for a whole new generation. They buy the tickets. What's in this one for them?
Story of the biggest man in entertainment for 30 years, singing the biggest songs.
Better dead than a doornail.
Not when you sing them.
Amazing fella. Don't you love him? Oh, you would. Look, pal, I'm gonna forget you ever mentioned an idea like this, because if it ever got out, you'd have the whole town laughing at you.
That's the best thing this town does.
Just begging for trouble, aren't you?
Give me some reasons.
He wants reasons.
That's only fair. Give him some.
Reasons. Look, I was singing in vaudeville at 15. Well, let's say when I was really getting underway in my 20s. You expect me to play a 20-year-old on the screen today?
I know. That one I wrestled with last night, but suppose somebody else played it.
Somebody else? But me sing, of course.
Of course.
You mean, put the songs to him like he was singing.
I know. A lot of the kick is how you put the songs over.
Oh, I'm not talking about that. I've seen 1,000 guys imitate me. Good, too, but this would be my stuff coming out of his mouth on the screen, just like I sang it.
I think it could be done.
Okay, pal. Let's say we found the guy and he's great, but look, the songs. Couldn't use the old recordings I made years ago. Is that right?
I'm afraid it is. The sound quality of those old recordings would be pretty bad today.
So, I'd have to sing them all over again, huh?
I guess you'd have to.
Just like I sang them back on Broadway, where your picture's gonna show how I used to knock them dead.
I happen to think you can.
Oh, brother, I know. I'm better than I was in Duluth 20 years ago. All that's happened since, not hitting very well on one cylinder and sing four keys lower.
Nobody would have known that last night.
Because that was Sonny Boy.
Why not anything else?
Anything else? Anything else, pal? Those mammies, those rockabies, you gotta give out.
And you think you couldn't do that?
Think I couldn't do it.
Have you tried?
No, he hasn't.
Then why don't you? Why not come into the studio and make a recording or two? When could you do that?
Hmm? What do I say to this madman?
Why, that you're free almost any time.
What's the matter? Butterflies. Like opening night on Broadway.
Let's have playback voice and orchestra.
Let me out of here. I'd rather spend a year in solitary. How can a man sing with the orchestra in Honolulu?
You look great. Now we'll hear it.
Say, look, maybe we ought to skip the whole thing.
Now we'll see.
I think you're going to like it.
Ready?
One, two, three, four.
Yesterday I heard a lover sigh. Goodbye. For me or my. Seven times he got aboard his train. And seven times he hurried back to kiss his love again and got up to say goodbye. Say don't cry. The choo-choo train that takes me away from you. No words can tell how sad it makes me. Kiss me to the end then. Do it over again. Watch for the mail. I'll never fail. If you don't get a letter, then you'll know I'm in jail. Don't cry, Tootie, don't cry. Goodbye, Tootie, goodbye.
What's all the mystery, Rob? What are we going to see?
I told you, a little experiment, that's all.
What's it got to do with me?
That's what we're going to find out. Okay, Bill, let's go.
Yesterday I heard a lover sigh. Goodbye, for me or my. Seven times he got aboard his train. And seven times he hurried back to kiss his love again and got up to say goodbye.
What's going on here? Who is that?
The choo-choo train that takes me.
That's a recording I made.
Of course it is.
But who's the guy that...
Kiss me to the end then. Do it over again. Watch for the mail. I'll never fail. If you don't get a letter, then you'll know I'm in jail. Don't cry, Tootie, don't cry. Goodbye, Tootie, goodbye.
Wonderful. Who was that?
Meet a young fellow named Larry Parks.
Let's agree on one thing at the start, boys. I don't think anybody cares about the facts of my life, about dates and places. I'll give you a mess up. You juggle them any way you like. What matters is the singing a man did and the difference that made. Thing to tell as a kid who ran away from home when he was 15 because he was crazy to sing. Never stopped once through all the years of show business, singing thousands of songs. A guy who ate, drank, and slept, nothing else. And when you get to Julie Benson, that's important. Because then you find out it's really the story of a wrong guy who only cared about being a big hit and always leading the parade. He thought he was crazy about her. When she walked out, though, if you ask him today, when she left, it was just his pride that was kicked around, because in those days, he really couldn't think of anything but himself. He had to get tossed on the shelf and take a beating before he began to learn there might be something else in the world. You know, I'm scared of this picture. If it ever went over, I might get wound up like the old Jolson again. I'd like to call the whole thing off.
You what?
Yeah, but my wife won't let me. Well, where are we?
Still at the beginning.
Oh, yeah.
I guess the place to start would be back in Washington when I was a kid singing with my father in the synagogue. But what I was really interested in was the burlesque house a few blocks down the street.
California, here I come. Right back where I started from. Where bowers of flowers bloom in the spring. Each morning at dawning, birdies sing.
You made me love you. I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You made me want to. And all the time you knew it. I guess you always knew it. You made me happy sometimes. Oh, you made me glad. But there were times, baby. You dog. You made me cry for. I didn't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you. I want some love, that's true. You know I do, indeed I do, yes I do.
Give me, give me, give me, give me what I cry for. You know you got the kind of kisses that I die for. You know you made me love you.
What's that you keep taking all the time?
Nothing, just a little something for my nerves.
Anything wrong with you?
No, no, feel fine, feel fine. What are you stalling around for? Come on, we'll be late.
The weather holds fair for the slalom, and then the snow begins to fly again. Jack Frost holds wintry court high in the magic wonderland of whirling white. The contestants, like the weather, run both hot and cold, and in all directions from pole to pole. But despite the heavy fall, some collegians average almost a mile a minute.
Let me sing a funny song with crazy words that roll along. And if my song can start you laughing.
Can I help you?
No, no, thanks. What's the matter? Pal, I just can't take it in there.
You mean you're not going to see the picture?
No, I'll watch it from back here. Maybe in later. You go on in.
You look a little groggy to me.
Oh, you're crazy. Go back in.
A low-down blues to lift you out of your seat. And if my song can reach your shoes and start you tapping your feet, I'm happy. Let me sing of Dixie's charms, of cotton fields and Mammy's arms. And if my song can make you homesick, I'm happy. Rosie, you are my posy. You are
in the moonlight. Yes, something sweet, love. I'm gonna sing about my baby, your honey, your boy I'm waiting. Those ruby, those lips to greet. Don't be so aggravating, my blushing rosy, my posy sweet.
It's all right. Kid's great. Me singing, you know.
Mammy, my little mammy, I'd walk a million miles for one of your smiles, my mammy, ah. Mammy, my little mammy, the sun shines east, the sun shines west. I know where the sun shines best. It's on my mammy I'm talking about. Nobody else's. My little mammy. My heart's strings are tangled around Alabama. Mammy, mammy, I'm coming. Ah, I hope I didn't make you wait. Mammy, mammy, I'm coming. Oh, I hope I'm not late. Mammy, look at me. Don't you know me? I'm your little baby. I'd walk a million miles for one of your smiles, my mammy. How I love you, how I love you, my dear old Swanee. The folks up north will see me no more when I get to that Swanee shore. He shall die,
he shall die,
he shall die,
he shall die,
he shall die till he I die, he shall jolly well die.
He shall die, I'll
kill him,
he shall die, I'll
kill him dead. For I'll raise up onion on his Spanish onion if I'm left in bending. Ta-da! Bowers, the flowers bloom in the spring. Each morning at dawning, birdies sing and everything. Hot sun, kiss, kiss, said, don't be late. That's why I can hardly wait. Come on, open up, open up, open up that golden gate, California. Here I come.
All right, Mr. Jolson.
Just a little tired.
Maybe you'd like to come back and sit in my office for a while, hmm?
Well, a minute or two, maybe.
And then the world is going to be mine, mine all mine. This evening, around a quarter to nine. The world was in bloom. There were stars in the skies, except for the few that were there in your eyes. Dear, as I held you close in my arms, angels were singing a hymn to your charms, to hearts gently beating, murmuring low. Darling, I love you so. Watch them shuffling along. See them shuffling along. It's every great mate.
They're in the nightclub now.
Waiting for the Robert E. Lee. April showers.
I've got to see the finish of this.
They bring the flowers.
Deal fine.
In May. So if it's raining, have no regrets, because it isn't raining rain, you know. It's raining violets, and where you see clouds upon the hills,
you soon will see crowds of daffodils. So keep on looking for a bluebird and listening for its song. Whenever April showers come
record doubled in Cincy. Amazing.
What town?
Cincy.
And I'd like to be your sister, brother, dad, and mother too. Pretty baby, pretty baby. Won't you come and let me rock you in my cradle of love? And we'll cuddle.
Jolson records on the radio all day long. Mama would be happy.
Hal, this radio offer, your own program, you got to make up your mind.
I say no, Steve.
I say yes.
But why, baby? What for?
It's your right to hear those Bobby Soxers squeal.
Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in the morning. No one could be sweeter than my sweetie when I meet her in the morning. Where the morning glories twine around the door, whispering pretty stories, I long to hear once more. Strolling with my girlie where the dew is curly early in the morning. Butterflies all flutter up and kiss each little buttercup at dawning. If I had a lad and lamb only a day, I'd make a wish, and here's what I'd say. Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in a morning. By your baby with a Dixie melody. When you croon a little tune from the heart of Dixie, hang that cradle, mammy mine, right on that Mason-Dixon line, and swing it from Virginia to Tennessee with all the soul that's in ya. Weep no more, my lady. Oh, sing it. Oh, sing it, mammy. Sing it for me. Old Black Joe, just as though you had me on your knee. A million baby kisses I'll deliver if you will only sing that Swanee River. Rock-a-bye, your rock-a-bye baby with a Dixie melody.